Hello, folks, and welcome to Rebel Assault, the first game that we're going to be doing here for Star Wars Month, or months, or Star Wars Season, as I'm naming it here on Twitch. So what Rebel Assault is, it's an on-rails shooter, came out in, I want to say it was like 93, 94, something like that. So it's an old DOS game. I'm actually playing it through DOSBox here. With any luck, it will work relatively well. In my testing, it seemed to work out all right. There's one thing I want to do real quick. Because this game can be a little difficult, and you're given only a set number of lives. So if you die, you have to end up using a password. Because this is in the era before you had all the different saving and all that. Or at least, for whatever reason, this game didn't implement saving. Omar says, title says retro, I shall sue you for false advertising. Hey, there's a guy playing the original Fallout on the retro channel, so I figure I'll go with retro. And Omar, this game is like, let's see, you were born in 2001, I think? So this game is like 8 years older than you, something like that, so I'm pretty sure it's considered retro. Anyways, let's get started here. So you do have to, well, it's recommended to use a joystick for this game. You can use a mouse and keyboard, but it's not the same. So fortunately, I still have a old joystick. So center, then upper left, then bottom right, and center. Omri says, bro, that's some Stone Age shit. Yep. Unfortunately, they don't have a Stone Age category, Omar. Well, this is gonna get flagged.
It is a period of civil war. Rebel spaceships, striking from a hidden base, have won their first victory against the evil Galactic Empire, who, under the command of Darth Vader, rule the galaxy with an iron fist. The Empire, however, is far from defeated. And many young unknown pilots have joined the rebels in the hope they can restore freedom to the galaxy.
Rookie One, welcome to Collidor.
Pickle says, look at those realistic graphics. I bet not even my RTX can run those. Believe it or not, this little full motion video or whatever it's called. That was like really cool back in the day because there wasn't really much in the way of big cinematics when this game came out. At least not that I know of anyways. So yeah, we don't need the credits. So let's continue past that. Omar says, sounds like a documentary on the Darth Vader in his natural habitat. All right, so we're going to go over to game options. We're going to set this. You can actually, this even gives you an option of choosing Rookie One as male or female. This is really innovating for the day. All right, we'll turn dialogue text to on. Controls are normal. Yeah, that should be fine. Difficulty, we're setting it to easy because otherwise even on easy, I'm still going to lose a lot. So, all right, exit menu and start new game.
It is morning at a rebel base on planet Tatooine, where a young pilot is embarking on a crucial training flight. Thank you.
Rookie One to TACCOM Control. Request clearance for departure.
This is TACCOM Control. Clearance granted. Is that you, kid?
Hack! Good to hear you! So you're running your trials today. I wish I could be with you.
You shouldn't have any problems. Beggar's Canyon isn't half as tough as the runs we used to do. Good luck.
Thanks.
All right. Hopefully I can do this without crashing in the first level. All right, don't laugh too much.
Green leader to Rookie One. Are you ready?
Yes, sir. Good. We're approaching the canyon run. Begin with basic flight maneuvers. Stay tight, follow our lead, and stay clear of the walls.
All right. So, oh dear. So even using a joystick, this thing does like to move. So you gotta avoid the walls here. As I said earlier, it is an on-rails sort of thing. So you're automatically going to follow along wherever it takes you. But you just have to avoid the sides, because that's where you're gonna take damage.
We're approaching a fork in the canyon. Green 2 will go left. You can go with him, but if you're really a hotshot, follow me to the right.
We'll try going to the right. Generally, it's not too bad, at least the times when I was testing this.
They're taking nice and easy through the pass up here. But get ready to make a sharp left.
This is also very much an arcade sort of game, because as you can see at the bottom right, it does have a little score screen. Actually, I'll take it back. This game does actually have saving, but it saves scores rather than saving, like, progress in the game. Pickle says, is that the demonetization I hear coming? God, this series is going to be flagged a lot. Yes, it is.
Congratulations, Rookie One. Now let's try a little target practice. Prepare to engage target drones. Shoot any we pass over, but stay with us.
Alright, so you gotta make sure you destroy at least a few drones here. Otherwise, it's gonna complain that you can't shoot for a crap. Oh dear. Oh, that was total luck that I got that one. Pickle says, oh, those graphics are so good. They're making me nuts on how good they are. Oh, dear. Yeah, I'm pretty sure graphics alone count this game as something that can be considered retro. No, you bitch. Oh well, I think I've gotten enough drones that I should be good. Yeah, whatever.
Well done, Rookie One. It looks like you've earned yourself an A-Wing. But don't try any stunts with Commander Farrell. He won't appreciate it.
Omer says, don't worry, we got donuts. I'll get a sugar crash before I get to laugh. Pickle says, also, I've been thinking. Thinking about what, Pickle?
Rookie One, this is Commander Farrell. Report in.
Rookie One, standing by, Commander.
Alright, before we begin, let's get something straight. I don't like hotshots. If you want to impress me, show me control and discipline. Without them, you won't stand a chance against the Empire. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now follow me into the asteroid field. Shoot the ice asteroids, but dodge the rocky ones.
Alright. So this is a deceptive little level, because you have to shoot asteroids, but you don't want to shoot all the asteroids. Because you're just gonna get sidetracked and end up running into some of the rocky asteroids here. Yeah. So some of them you have to hit, some of them you have to avoid. Definitely a deceptive little level. Pickle asked you a question about getting VR. I would say you'd probably want to get a solid state drive first. And then after that, you could probably save up to do VR. Only thing that I might be a little cautious with is keep in mind, you know, your current living situation with all your little cousins or whatever. Or, nieces or nephews or whatever. All the little children. If they decide to, you know, do what they did. To your graphics card and... So that would be my only consideration as far as getting VR for you. Because it says I'm gonna get fighting games, so I accidentally hit children. Get Gorn! Then you can tear the heart out from one of the children. Accidentally. Alright, so this is like one of the worst levels for avoiding walls. Pickle says also some you have to put some sensors in the room. I think yeah, something like that. Like at least a like you do need like a webcam or something, if I recall correctly, for doing it. I don't know if it's a special kind of webcam related to it or what. Oh god. Overcorrected way too much there. If I can make it through this without crashing once, that will be impressive. Because generally, this level here takes me down to my last life. Here we go down. Yeah, I don't need to play a horror game. This is horror enough. Oh god.
Well done, Rookie. We can use more pilots.
I was almost doomed there.
Follow me to base and we'll get you assigned to a squadron. And while we're waiting, I'll let you buy me a drink for that fancy flying.
Omar says, God, they are scary. They look like a failed attempt at a synth. Hey, I think this is why my password is always Falcon. Because I always get Falcon in this game. Pickle says, first I'll have to convince my parents to get a lock for my room, which I have tons of evidence on why. Well, the reason, the fact that you haven't gotten it yet.
Meanwhile, in space over Tatooine.
Lord Vader. Within moments, our troops will board their ship. We'll then have the stolen plans back in our possession.
I will say it is a little creepy how some of the people in this game look more animated, and then they take this guy, and it's like they took General Veers and just put a whole different face on this guy.
We're doomed. I'm afraid there'll be no escape for the princess this time. R2-D2, where are you going? Secret mission? What plans? I'm not getting in there. It's restricted. Oh, I'm going to regret this. Are you sure this thing is safe? Lord Vader, the battle station plans are not on board this ship.
and no transmissions were made. An escape pod was jettisoned during the fighting. No life forms were present.
She must have hidden the plans in the escape pod. Send a detachment down to retrieve them. See to it personally, Commander. There'll be no one to stop us this time.
Omar says, yeah, tonight, Total War Empire won't be my worst nightmare.
Have you ever flown in?
Attention all pilots, report to battle stations immediately. Tatooine base is under attack.
Well, kid, I think it's time you graduated to an X-Wing.
Okay, team, this is for real now. Check in.
Rookie One, standing by.
Mira, standing by.
Good. Stay sharp. There's a Star Destroyer in orbit. Probably coordinating the attack below. We'll have to take out its command center. Or we won't stand a chance on the surface. Okay, here we go.
Pickle says, I wonder how escape pods work in Star Wars. And Omar says, we need an anime of Star Wars? I know there's a really cool little TIE fighter anime. Little anime short that was done on YouTube. Okay, so your goal here, you gotta take out all of the turrets along the Star Destroyer. Very similar to what Finn and Poe did, escaping from the Resurgent class Star Destroyer in The Force Awakens. Then you got these TIE fighters that come along. You want to make sure to take them out, otherwise if they get past you, you will take further damage. Then we begin the assault on the bridge. So we gotta take out the shield generators. And oh my god, this kills my poor fingers. Like, I can feel it right through here. So if you want a workout for your wrists, this is definitely it. Get a few more shots on this shield generator. I want to say when I was doing my little test run, it took me about 3 passes to get it all done. Pickle says, how did they manage not to become a pancake when they hit the ground? So I actually had a toy escape pod when I was a kid, and it actually has thrusters on the front of it that I assume go towards preventing it from completely becoming a pancake, as you called it. Alright, port side guns are down. For those wondering, port is to the left. Wait, I remember that. Port and lefts are 4 letters. And then, by the power of deduction, starboard is to the right. Actually, when I was a kid, took a little boating class, and I actually learned how to drive a boat. Because at least here in Illinois, you gotta have a license to do that as well. Like a motorized boat. I actually learned how to drive a boat before I learned to drive a car. As weird as that may sound. Pickle says, imagine this game in VR. I want to say that the first of EA's Battlefront games was maybe something like this. I don't know if it was on rails like this, but probably visually it was rather similar. It's unfortunate that they didn't extend that mode into Battlefront 2. But from what I've heard, it was actually a decent mode overall. Although this game probably wouldn't do very well in VR just because it's such low quality. In VR, you generally want something, at least my general sense, is you want good quality. Otherwise, you have a tendency of getting that motion sickness. Pick says, in California, you need a license for anything. Want to walk? You'll need a license for that. Also, I totally took out one of those ties looking at your message there. A force. A force is with me. Maybe. Come on, shield generator. Pickle says, I installed Battlefront, but then I uninstalled it. Did you even play it? Oh. Omar says, typical thing to do with EA games, true. And Pickle says, nope. Yeah, I'm almost to the point of wanting to uninstall 76, too. Also, I posted something in the game section on Discord that kind of pissed me off of something a guy said on the Fallout 76 subreddit, like, oh, I already subscribed to it, you know, screw you people if you can't afford $13 a month. I mean, seriously? It's not so much affordability, it's worth. And what Bethesda's offering with 76 there, not even worth the,
Rookie One, arm your torpedoes and make
worth the $13 a month or $100 a year. Alright. Come on. Oh, did I miss? I missed. No, I hit it! Aha!
Great shot. Now let's get down there and hope we're not too late.
Pick says, I thought, what the fuck am I doing? I could use this space for more interesting games. True. Pickle says, yeah, screw us for not wasting money on pointless and garbage things.
Anchorhead Base, come in.
This is Anchorhead Base.
Mayday, we are under attack.
Hold on, Hack. We're on our way.
Better hurry, kid. We're in pretty bad shape. Are we two? No, wait, make it three TIE fighters. They're firing! Ah! Hack!
You know, there are so many southern people in this game. You got Harris, he's got a southern twang. You got Hack here, who just died. He had a southern twang.
We have to take them out before they can alert their command of our presence.
I'm pretty sure they already know of our presence since they just destroyed us. Just saying. Oh my god, I hate this. This part I hate too. Because you only really get one good shot at them, and then after that, it's like you completely lose any chance of hitting them again.
We don't have much time.
Fuck you, Rue Merlin. Yep, it's gone. Because it says, yeehaw, I'ma fuck my cousin. This is what I hear when I hear southern people. Oh god, now I've missed two of them. Oh. There we go. Oh.
Same as to Merlin. Need a little help out here?
Glad you could join us, Captain. The Empire is deploying ground forces at the Moscow.
Cardia, hello!
Let's do what we can here and regroup at Gamma Base.
Check. Rookie One?
I read you, Commander.
Take out as many ground targets as you can. I'll cut off their supply lines. When it gets too heavy, leave orbit and rendezvous with the fleet. I'll join you later. Out!
And Omar, we all know you weren't joking about calling me a stormtrooper. It's what you called me back in Fallout 4. Alright, so this one, you don't even have to worry about anything. This is all just a free-for-all. Like, when I first did this level, long time ago, I thought you had to avoid buildings or something. Nah. Just shoot everything down. Pickle says, to be honest, you're not a stormtrooper. Courteous says, maybe a nerf herder. Also, hopefully this looks better on the more square screen than it does in full screen here, because in full screen this is like... The one bad thing about some of these older games, put them in the full screen on a widescreen monitor does not work out very well. Now, Cardia, you've played some older games. Have you ever played this game? I will say for the eight, for back when this came out, and I'm thinking 93, I can't quite remember, it did look really good. You know, keep in mind this was playing on DOS and all that. Oh, Cardia says, to be honest, not this old. Avoid the asteroids, destroy the incoming TIEs, and some of the, oh god. Also makes you think, which way is the, asteroid gonna go sometimes? Because, you know, being on a, being on rails, you don't always have a, not like you have full control. So you may think you're going one way, and then you go another way, like what happened there. Oh god. Don't hit anything. I will say I'm kind of sad that there aren't more games that require a joystick. I mean, yeah, you know, you have controllers, you know, the Xbox controller and all that, and games that have support for those, but, you know, there is a difference playing a game with a controller where it feels like you're actually piloting something versus, like, on an Xbox controller. Oh, god. Oh! Ready, it says East Combat in Space.
Stay on course, Harris. We'll lose them in the asteroid field.
See, this is what I was talking about when we did the first asteroid mission. Is you get all these little targets that you want to go after. When they're like false targets. Oh, jeez. Cardia says, yes, like KOTOR and Doom. I know you can increase GFX for most PC-capable games. Yeah, something like this game, though, you probably can't because of how the graphics are rendered. Like, I think to an extent you can do some stuff, but... probably with, like, anti-aliasing, but... I didn't look through all of the settings on DOSBox. See what I could do to change it up. I did do some stuff because Dark Forces is going to be one of the games I look to play as well for Star Wars season here. And I did find one setting that hopefully will make it look a little bit better versus its base, you know, appearance. Not a big improvement, but it still should be a little something. Oh god. Almost be out of the asteroid field. Oh, I missed that one. Oh, I missed the TIE fighter. Or TIE interceptor, technically. Forget. I don't think when I was testing this, I did the whole level. This seems a lot longer than what I remember. So I may not have actually done this level since, because I was only doing some basic testing to see how this game would work. So yeah, I don't think I've done this level since I last played through this game, which was... 2005-ish, almost? Maybe I played through it on my old laptop at one point. Oh god. Whew. Cardias, how do you like this game, Newbie Plays? For the most part, I do actually enjoy this game. It's something to play through, you know, every now and then. It definitely gets the heart pumping. You know, I like these old cinematics too. It just seems so, like... even though some of the stuff like this for this Hoth sequence probably totally mess up some of the canon or even the old expanded universe canon, but
Lord Vader, we have yet to find any sign of the rebels.
I just find these old cinematics so interesting.
I am not interested in your excuses, Commander. The rebels are in this sector.
Yes, sir. Then it is only a matter of time. Our drones will most certainly find them.
Curtis says these graphics, I'm dying. Yeah, as I mentioned before you got in here, the fact that they change up some of the animations, like, some of the people look animated, and then some of the people, like that Imperial officer,
there's another one, sir.
Look like they just put someone else's face onto General Veers.
Do we have anyone in that quadrant?
Rookie One's not far from there.
Good, then check it out. If it is a probe, I want it and any others destroyed before they detect us.
So I'm not even sure if...
find out what it is, and if it is a probe, destroy it immediately.
I'm not even sure if this is supposed to be Hoth. I mean, it definitely looks like Hoth. But it could be another ice world, for all we know.
Gamma Base, I have positive identification of an Imperial probe droid.
Copy that, Rookie One. Destroy it. We'll begin evacuation procedures.
I might be fighting AT-AT's, Pickle. Oh, why do we have to follow it into a cave? If I remember correctly, I think I have to keep going through this cave until I destroy all of the probes.
Rookie
controls are so much worse now. You do have to go through here until you destroy all the probes. Oh my goodness. I will say that about this game, there are certain levels that do really piss you off. And I think this is one of them. Omar says that's a conveniently large cave. True. Pickle, you want me to say AT-AT instead of AT-ATs? Either one is kinda acceptable. Kinda being the keyword. Oh god, oh god. Yes, I'm aware it's critical. Oh my god.
Rookie One! Come in, Rookie One! Rookie One, this is Outpost Control. Can you read me?
Game over. Alright, just gonna skip this little, sequence. Okay. Newbie, enter. Alright, so what level was that? Pickle says, ready for your day off tomorrow, newbie? I am. Especially after going through all of that stuff from yesterday at work. Alright. Was that level 6 or level 7 here? Let's see. 2 A-Wing, 3 other A-Wing, 4 X-Wing, 5... What? Or was it 6? Okay, so Anowatz is the latest one. Oh, let's try it again, I guess. Yes, yes. We'll try this one more time. But this may be one of the levels I skip. Fortunately, with all the passcodes, you can get passcodes to, just go on to another level, so, Though I hope those passcodes aren't like for hard mode or something. That one totally sucks. Oh my goodness. Well, I could try using a mouse. The mouse might work better. There's a little bit better control. The only problem is the mouse is... Because the controls are made for a joystick, Trying to do this with a mouse, everything is upside down. Yeah, this is not working better with the mouse at all. Not working better. Let's see. Pickle says music is a bit distracting. Omar says, I'm amazed you can shoot through all these pixels. Must be the force of the 90s. Alright, let me exit to... Okay, let me just crash here. Come on, come on. I'm just going to skip through this. I think this is level 6. I think, I hope. So let's see. Oh, they do actually have different passwords for different modes. Okay. On the little cheat screen. Okay. Crash. Please crash. Just crash. Also, Pickle, do you think I should turn down the sound a little bit here? Versus my voice volume? I am cheating, Omar. I am cheating. Let's see. I think I can turn it down, actually. Well, music is on. Volume at 100%. And Pickle says C. Okay. Let me... So let's try 75% for desktop audio. All right. Exit the menu, enter passcode. I don't know where all these passcodes come from, though, because like the passcode I have on the screen that I'm looking at doesn't even exist. So let's try this. Derlin. Maybe it has to be capitalized? Oh no, are you not going to let me enter other passcodes? Are the passcodes? Okay, hold on. I didn't actually try out these passcodes before, which I see may have been a mistake. Also, a little side note, this is actually came out in 1993. Press this sequence when the LucasArts logo appears. Up, fire, down, fire, left, fire, right, fire. Oh, that's for cheat mode, okay. Pickle says, is it raining outside for you, newbie? I don't think so. Not that I noticed anyways. So again, it gives me all of these passcodes, but none of these passcodes work for me. Why? All right, well, let's see. No, we don't want to do that. Let me try and see if I can get into cheat mode. But I got to get to the LucasArts logo for that. Hmm. Hold, I'm going to try exiting the game. Pickle says, newbies gameplay, 20% playing, 30% cheating, 50% looking up those cheats. And Omar says, the 90s force is outpowering your cheats force. All right, let me resize this. Problem with using DOSBox is it does like to resize things. Okay, so for this cheat mode that it's talking about, up fire, down fire, left fire, right fire. So let's see, get past this. Up fire, down fire, left fire, right fire. Aha! So it should make that little funky noise. Oh, and I gotta resize this again. Okay. Press one of the following keys during gameplay to go to the selected level. So Imperial Probe Droids is where we were, so we want to try going to Imperial Walkers. Right?
It is morning.
Aha! Chapter 8, Imperial Walkers. So I can do plus or minus from the keypad to increase or decrease damage.
Delta 513, Mark 4. Copy that.
Because it says, look, an AT-AT.
I'm locking in your navigation computer. Arm your assault guns? Now, follow me.
What do you mean, choose my attack run? Oh! Don't use minus, that adds more damage in cheat mode. Okay, I think I understand. So the more lit up areas are where you're supposed to attack. I didn't understand this when I played this a long, long time ago. But you're supposed to attack the more lit up areas, and then those lit up areas, I guess when you've damaged them, will no longer trigger damage for the walker. Says, do it, use it. No, I'm not trying to blow myself up. Even though I could, just to show the death sequence. Pickle says, do it. Fine, I will do it. There, are you happy, Pickle? I blew myself up. I probably have to redo this whole sequence again. No. What do you mean, no?
I'm locking in your navigation computer. Arm your assault guns? Now, follow me. Choose your attack run. I'll cover for you.
I want to do the A attack run. Need more explosions? Aww. Well, hopefully we'll get that when we attack the Death Star. Not noticing much of a difference with this attack run.
Thank you.
Look, just like when the original Empire Strikes Back came out, you can see through the walkers. Or no, you could actually, what it was with Empire Strikes Back, you could see through the cockpit of the, that's what it was, the cockpit of the speeder. You know, this mission gives you a lot of points. Because my score is up to 4,900 so far.
One more pass.
Probably should have done attack run B that time. Oh well, hopefully I can finish off this walker. It's only 39%. But yeah, there's a lot of things in this game that kind of mess up the canon of Star Wars, because, for example, in The Empire Strikes Back, Luke says that the armor on the walkers is too strong for blasters. In this instance, though, we're using blasters to take out this walker. Also, the fact that you get no help from the AI at all is very infuriating. Dr. Pigeons, hello! Haven't seen you in a while. I'm doing okay. Playing through Star Wars Rebel Assault here, which I haven't done in eons. Has its fun moments, but can be a little irritating. I had to kind of enable cheat mode to bypass a level that was completely infuriating. Because as I wonder, what if you put thrusters and wings on a walker? I think there is an aquatic version of a walker. It's not exactly that, but it's kinda. Okay, there's the neck piece I have to get. Oh dear. Yes, I do like my cheats. With any luck, though, I shouldn't need to use cheats when we get to Dark Forces. I think I can do Dark Forces without cheats. I think being the key word. But hey, just like Omar says, you know, or I don't know if he says it, but you know, he means it. Cheats are good for games. Pickle says, I think otherwise. You think I'll need cheats for Dark Forces? I know how it'll go when I go up against the Dark Troopers. But the good thing about Dark Forces is you get bigger guns to use. So yeah, you start out with a measly blaster, but eventually you get up to the Dark Trooper's own assault cannon. Oh, it's almost down. Oh! Just has to get to 10%. So, Pickle, think of the BFG, but it has a missile option as well.
Is still out there.
I'm sorry, there's no time. We must evacuate immediately.
They're abandoning me, those bastards. What am I drinking? Just water. Oh my god, look at that walking animation there.
There he is.
And look at that. Oh my god, they have just a regular stormtrooper here.
Wait, you, Paul.
And not even like a snowtrooper. Oh my god. Have I done this part? You know what? Now that I think about it, I don't think I've ever actually completed this game, because I don't remember this section. Or do I? I know Rebel Assault 2 has a section like this. And the animations in Rebel Assault 2, even though it's a somewhat newer game, somewhat by like maybe 2 years, but they're still just as atrocious. Oh dear. We're doing so bad, Omar. I had to say something in Arabic. Omar, would you care to translate? Let's go to the right, even though I generally go to the left.
Stop right there.
Stop right there, criminal stump. Omar says, I don't like sand, it's rough, irritating, and it gets everywhere. Oh my god, this is such a bad shooting experience. I mean, I'll say I like the fact that this is easy. Because it says, at least the animation is better than the Fallout 76 ones. Alright, are we continuing to the right? Go upstairs, I guess. Oh, maybe we're going up? I'm not entirely sure if we're going up or down. I guess we're going up. How am I supposed to fire down? Okay, this was a horrible idea. Because for whatever reason, I can't, oh, I guess you're just supposed to survive that somehow? Alright, let's try going left then, I guess. Are we sliding through this? Apparently we're sliding through it. I got an extra life! Because says, oh, that running. Now, see, Omar, that's true, Stormtrooper brain. Omar says, this looks like a game you find on a website with a shit ton of ads. I can't disagree. Chapter 10, Protect... Oh, I remember. I did actually get to this point. I think... Oh, I remember this level. I hate this level. Anything where you're protecting something. I haven't done this in cheat mode before, so maybe this level is easier. I can't remember if you just have to destroy things, or if there is a section where you actually have to protect the transport. It wouldn't be so bad if you just held down and it would continue to fire. We have to do each individual little attack by clicking on it, so. Or hitting the fire key on the joystick. Do you watch Anime Newbie? Not really. I've watched some here and there. The only anime that I ever really got into was Digimon. That was back a long time ago. Like, any of the newer Digimon I haven't really gotten into. Pickle says, ooh? What, about anime or about Digimon specifically? And I missed your thing. Yeah, Pickle, he did sound... He did sound chill about being left to die. Password, Minoc.
The rebels have escaped, sir.
There's that face again.
Set course for the Death Star. We have the princess. She's my link to finding their secret base.
In his continuing quest to locate the rebels, Darth Vader unleashes the immense destructive power of the Death Star on Alderaan.
Here's your explosion, Pickle.
Sympathetic to the rebels, and home to Princess Leia.
The target has been destroyed, sir. What is our new heading?
We have the location of the secret rebel base. Set course for the Yavin system.
Right away, Lord Vader.
Yavin training.
An analysis of the plans
provided by Princess Leia has demonstrated a weakness in the battle station. You're required to maneuver straight down this trench and skim the surface to this point. The target area is only 2 meters wide. A precise hit will start a chain reaction that should destroy the station.
The Death Star will enter this system within 3 hours. To prepare for its arrival, we will run a series of training exercises. Split up into your assigned squadrons. May the Force be with you.
Blue 3, come in.
Blue 3, standing by.
You begin. Navigate the riverbed. Knock out as many targets as you can.
So is Rookie 1 now Blue 3? Oh my goodness. I hate these missions where I have to avoid crashing into stuff because I... Just imagine me playing GTA. And how... Actually, I can drive alright in GTA 5. GTA 4? Oh, that was bad. Come on, I need a few more hits here, I think. Like, a lot more hits, actually. This is not very forgiving at all with the amount of damage that they give you for hitting those walls. Oh, is 10 hits good enough? I hope so. Oh no, there's more. But wait, there's more. And I couldn't even hit any of those other ones.
Blue Squadron, set course for rendezvous point. The Death Star has entered the system. You heard him. Let's do it for real now. Launch.
Nickel says I once drove through a school. Omar says, there's an anime I liked. I forgot what it was called, but basically it was humans fighting aliens to find they aren't aliens but normal people betrayed by the government. I don't recognize the name of that, or the description of that. Also, Blue Squadron totally was supposed to have died at Scarif. Not be present for the Death Star battle. Omar says the main character is from Mars. And Pickle says, or Pickle asks Doom? I'm dead. I figured I wouldn't cheat for that one to see what the death animation looks like. I will say another thing I enjoy about these games is you do get the death animations, so that's always entertaining to see. Even though this game has a lot of arcade elements, I don't think this game ever actually was in an arcade. I want to say there was a console version of this game that was on the Sega CD or something like that. There's also a console version of Rebel Assault 2. That's on the old original PlayStation. Original PlayStation also had Dark Forces. Alright, let's heal. We saw the death animation for this level. We don't need to see it again. Homer says, quote, I'm dead. What? Oh. What every nation said when they saw my army marching into their land. Oh, Sims is dead. Ah, crap.
Stay tight, here they come.
Okay, this one you have to protect someone on. Gotta protect damn Sims from dying. Because God forbid we go without Sims here. Room Merlene to take over. I will say, I don't think I lost a pilot from losing Sims there. Pickle says, gotta go, food calls. Okay, Pickle. Talk to you later. Sims, don't die for the level. No, damn it. Alright, so we're gonna test. Nope, you don't lose any pilots for losing Sims. So that's good at least. So Sims can die all day. They'll just have you repeat it until you can save Sims. It's interesting. Omar says, oh, I guess I have to tell weird jokes now. Yep, because Piccolo is gone. Responsibility is to you, Omar. Oh god, don't die. My underwear went so far up my ass, I feel violated. Oh dear, Omar. I don't know what to say to you. Approaching the Sims part. Come on. Come on. Nope, nope, damn it. Oh dear. How many times is Sims going to die? We're at 3 now.
There's one coming up back. I've got him.
Omar says, remind me about what I said when my underwear runs for Congress. Eh, maybe it'll go straight for President Omar. There is not an a way you can save your progress at a certain point in the game. Come on. No. We're at 4 times now.
Abort approach.
Omar says I don't think it will, too brown for it to run. Oh god. Oh, interesting. So even though you don't lose pilots, you do keep your damage. Firehawk, thanks for the follow. Omar says, I can't tell if I'm having deja vu or you're just bad. Come on, Omar, we know the answer to that. Even with cheating, I can't get through this level. Ha ha ha. I'm doing okay, Firehawk. How are you? Yes! Oh god. It's not over yet. So Firehawk, have you ever played Rebel Assault here? Heal. Firehawk says hope. I'm assuming that means nope. I don't blame you. Rebel Assault is probably among the lower popularity of Star Wars games. You know, it's probably even lower than like Star Wars Rebellion. Star Wars Rebellion, I think, is probably like one of the underrated Star Wars games. This one, it has its ups and downs. The difficulty curve on this game is extensive. That's why I'm cheating, for example. But, you know, all games in the 90s could be very difficult. I don't even think I ever actually finished any of the Super Mario games except for 2. Omar says, a new viewer, welcome to our community. Question, can you tell weird jokes? Chapter 13, Death Star Surface. Is this the last mission or is there one more? Might be one more.
Start your approach. Accelerate to attack speed.
It'll be my pleasure. I'm going in.
This is Blue Leader. Blue 3, start your run.
Okay, we can do this. Just keep your eyes open.
Oh, it's one of these levels. Think you're doing good, then suddenly bam, a whole bunch of damage. Does the point of view change when you're going from back all the way? It does change, doesn't it? Omar says, I see he's into silent comedy. We have to take out all of the guns in this area. Oh no, let's just shoot them up pretty much. Target accuracy 17%. Still gave me a bonus though.
It's
a big cannon.
The turret's too heavily armored. We'll have to open her up and take out the power relays below.
Take out the shield, this massive thing.
Okay, let's go in.
Sweet. Oh God. This is yeah, this part would be very bad in VR because this is disorienting even in Are we flying out? Why are we flying out now? Yeah, that's very disorienting. I would not want to do that in VR. I know that's pretty much what Poe does in The Force Awakens. Streak going. Omar asks, are you not driving? No, so this is all an on-rails sort of shooter. You can do little things to kind of change a little, but most of the driving is all done automated. So think of yourself on a roller coaster, an interactive sort of roller coaster where you get to fire on all this stuff. Yeah, for the most part, I think a lot of on-rails sort of games have kind of gone out of favor. The last on-rails sort of gaming experience that I had, or as far as new gaming experience anyways, there's a little space flight thing that came out with Star Wars The Old Republic, the MMO RPG, that came out initially before they did their Starfighter thing, and that was all on rails as well. Firehawk says, did you ever play the summoning for PC on DOS? Summoning? I don't think I did. It doesn't ring a bell, not off the top of my head. I think I may have played something called the Summoner on one of the consoles, like GameCube or something. But not the Summoning. Not that I remember, anyways. I don't think there's any relation to him, but... Omar says, what the fuck? I thought you were a really good driver. Oh, no, no. Come on, Omar. You should know better than that. You saw my driving in Space Engineers. Now, Firehawk, how would you describe the summoning? Oh, I missed it. Missed that one, too, and that one. Oh, my. By the time we take this thing out, the Death Star will have fired and destroyed Yavin 4. We're gonna be here for a while, folks. I can't take out that last TIE fighter for the life of me either. You know, we got different attack runs that we could do on those walkers. Why can't we get a different attack run here? I got one. Oh, and that's probably the only one I'm gonna get. Thank you. Firehawk says, I do love to play PC DOS games a lot, like the Summoning, Lynx 386 Pro, Hardball 386, and Wing Commander. I played Wing Commander. I think Wing Commander is one that I wanted to play, but I never actually had the opportunity to play it. Yeah, DOS had some pretty neat games, especially considering, you know, the technology and all that at the time. Other DOS games that I like are some of the old LucasArts adventure games. Those are really neat. Password Dagobah.
Rebel ships, Lord Vader. But they're so small, they're avoiding our turbo lasers.
We must destroy them ship to ship. Get the crew to their fight. And prepare my interceptor.
Omar says, I played this game when I was a kid and I loved it a lot. It was the Chicken Little game. Oh, God.
I'll take the lead. Blue 3, cover my tail. Blue 2, watch the rear. Let's go.
All right. I think this game has something about... something about taking out all the Southerners. And no, Piccolo, I have not seen Chicken Little. I know the game, or I know the movie, but... but no, I have not seen the movie. Did I call you Pickle Omar? Oh no. Shame.
Hey, don't you know you shouldn't be flying up here alone?
Firehawk says Steam has a new Star Wars game coming out soon. Yep. That's why I'm doing Star Wars Season as also part of November here. And not just December. I will be playing Jedi Fallen Order. So definitely looking forward to that. Especially for the fact that it's going to be the first Star Wars game since... well, I mean, Battlefront had a little bit of a story, but it didn't have a long story. Oh my god, I'm hitting like everything here. It's away!
Yahoo!
Chapter complete! Why do I get a password for this too? Does this game continue on after this? I can't remember.
The defeat of the Death Star was a major conquest for the Rebel Alliance. For the Rebels had proven themselves a force to be reckoned with. For the moment, victory was theirs.
You have defeated me this time.
Oh, Rookie One stole Luke Skywalker's jacket. Omar says, I'm hitting everything here. Newbie's description of driving. All right, well, that is Star Wars Rebel Assault. I'm glad I was able to finish it in the, you know, couple hours of streaming here that I was able to do. Finished it much quicker than if I did not cheat, because if I didn't cheat, I'd have to use those passwords, and yeah, it would have been a mess. Firehawk asked, does anyone here want the Empire from Star Wars to take over our world? Sometimes. You know, certainly the Empire couldn't do any worse than any of our other governments, so. Plus, you know, the Empire doesn't seem super prejudiced towards humans, so, you know, we got that going for us. But yeah, what did you guys think of Rebel Assault here? I'll say it's certainly a game I have nostalgia for. Is it a game that I'd play all the time, like, say, Empire War, or, even Star Wars Rebellion I like to play a lot, but Rebellion is a whole different matter. Omar says, if I enjoy being fucked in the ass, then yes. Are you talking about the Empire there? What was that thing about Rue Merlin as herself? What? It's not an actual Rue Merlin, is there? I don't know. What is this? Also, I miss the LucasArts and the LucasArts guy and all that. It was a different time with LucasArts. Omar says, burn this game in the trash for that face animation. New high score. I should have put cheater. Oh well. Omar says, I ain't sleeping tonight. No, you're not, Omar. No, you're not. Normal? Oh, so maybe doing the cheat took me into normal mode. That's why I was taking so much damage in some of those things. Okay, that could be. But yeah, that was interesting. So on tomorrow, we're going to be starting Star Wars Dark Forces. Now, that one is a shooter, very similar to Doom. It even looks quite a bit like Doom. It has some different things going for it, though. For example, you can look up and down in that versus Doom, where you're completely on a horizontal plane. But yeah, that should be fun. Dark Forces is probably something that's going to take us a few days to do, though. Well, it is going to be a longer stream tomorrow because I'm off. So that we have going for us. I still don't think we're going to be able to complete it in 4 hours, but we'll see. But yeah, Dark Forces is a shooter. And that eventually leads up into Dark Forces 2, Jedi Knight, which I hope that we can get to. I think we should be able to get to Jedi Knight at the very least and complete that before Jedi Fallen Order comes out. Hopefully, anyways, being the key word. And then the general idea is we'll get through Jedi Knight. Fallen Order will come out. We'll start with that. After Fallen Order, I haven't decided where we'll go yet. Certainly, Empire at War is an option. Plenty of modding opportunity there to do. Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds has some decent stuff. That's a RTS sort of game, very similar to Age of Empires 2. It's actually built off the Age of Empires 2 engine. What else do we have going on? Oh, there's a lot of different options. Omar, I was going to ask, did you ever complete Republic Commando? Because that was another game that we could actually check out in Star Wars season here, since it's a rather popular Star Wars game, you know, came out a long time ago. Well, relatively long time ago. I'm going to say it was like 2004, or did it actually come out in 2005? Let's see. Republic Commando. Oh, it was 2005. Okay. But yeah, that's an option as well. A few different console options. Most of them I can emulate, so that will be taken into consideration. I know one of my friends mentioned Masters of Terras Kasi or whatever as something to play. Definitely something I could look into. It kicked my ass the last time I tried to play it. But, you know, it's something to try. Omar says, no, the game glitched me into a place I was not supposed to be in, and I lost my saves. Oh, noes. All right, folks, so thanks for joining me. If you haven't already, be sure to follow me here on Twitch so you can stay tuned when I do my streams for Star Wars Month here. General stream time is Saturday, Sunday at 2 p.m. Central, and Wednesdays at 9 p.m. Central. There will be some extra streams added in when Fallen Order comes out. So probably Thursday streams and a different time for the Wednesday stream, the launch nights. So thanks for watching, folks. Also, be sure to join the Discord so you can hang out when I am off stream, and I will see you all later.